everyone. Thank you guys for coming out today. This is the biggest day, or one of the biggest days of our lives, and we really appreciate everyone for traveling near and far to come share in our big day with us. And we appreciate you, and we love all of you.
Hey, how y'all doing? My name is Ravi Smith. I just want to thank y'all for coming out to celebrate me and Jessica's day. Y'all get to hear the story of how me and my love just fell in love with each other and how I just knew she was my wife, and I just want y'all to experience it with me. So I just want y'all to check it out.
Ravi and I met while at the University of Louisiana at Monroe. I was a junior at the time and he was a sophomore. Ravi, I'm sure he'd have a different story than myself. However, Ravi sent me a Facebook message asking me had I studied for a test in a class. And I told him he knew that we did not have a class together at all. And he used that to try to wedge his foot in the door with me. And eventually he said, well, hey, how about we go to a movie through a Facebook message? And I was very skeptical because I just transferred from Northwestern State and I was nervous. I didn't know anyone on campus. I felt like the new kid on the block, although I was a junior. And I agreed, and we went out on a date.
Okay, me and Jessica met, at ULM. You know, we both went to the University of Louisiana Monroe. It just happened this one day after football practice. I seen her in the sub. I'm like, man, I never seen this girl before. Like, this girl is different from all the other girls. And of course, I was with me and my boys, and I asked my boys if they have a name around her. So ain't none of them know her name until I had to ask one of her friends, which I didn't know was her friends at the time, her name. So once I got the name Jessica, I'm like, okay. So I just knew from that point on that I knew I couldn't leave, couldn't graduate ULM without having this girl notice me, or at least having a chance to try to holler at this girl at least. So what I did was I posted on social media. You know, I got her name, looked at a couple of pictures of her, and I just tried to approach her like, you know, oh, hey, how you doing? My name is Robert Smith, you know, because at the time I'm very shy, so I didn't know how to approach her. When I did see her, she was looking real mean, so I was like, you know, maybe I'll just do it the subtle way on the internet. So we start, you know, communicating with each other, and she started, you know, laughing at everything I said, which I didn't think I was funny, but she was laughing at it, so, you know, and that's how we came along.
What attracted me to Ravi was his sense of humor. He's very handsome. He's very presentable. I love the way that he dressed. He kept himself very neat. And he was very respectable. He was honest. He told me straight up that he liked me and that he wanted a relationship. He was very persistent.
What attracted me to her was that she was different. She was just motivated in everything that she do. That's the only girl that just made me feel like I can conquer the world and everything I do. And what really attracted me to her, after a couple of dates, she said, you know, Robert, how about I take you out? And I never had that happen to me before. And after that happened, you know, I just fell in love instantly. Like, I didn't have to pay. And I kept on asking her, like, you sure you don't need me to get this? Show me to get dessert, leave the tip or something? She said, no, I got it. And after that, I just know that was going to be the love of my life.
I knew Ravi was the one when I introduced him to my parents. Larry and Ellen are not easy people to come around. They are not people to accept ones that we date. But when they gave me the okay, I knew that he was the one. And also when I met his mother and his father, they welcomed me with open arms. Our families get along well, and we are all like one big family. I knew that he was the one. After that moment,
I knew I could see myself with her for the rest of my life was when I had pneumonia, and I was in the hospital for like a week or so. But what happened was I told her she can go home and she can just have to worry about me. But what she did that just set it off for me was that she stayed with me the whole week. Like, she didn't leave her bed. So the only time she went home was when she went to get some clothes and she came back to come spend the night with me. So us in that little hospital bed, I know it was uncomfortable for her, but it really made my day, and it really made me just feel like, okay, she's the one. I can't get nobody else like that to come just spend the night in that little old bed with me. So I just appreciate her for that, and I just knew she was the one after that.
Ravi proposed to me on the night of my hooding ceremony for my graduate degree at Grambling State University. It was on a Wednesday night. I was a little skeptical because we had talked about marriage. We both agreed that we would hold off on marriage until we both obtained our master's degrees. And so I was a little skeptical, but after a while, when I told him that I wanted a particular present instead of anything else, without hinting that I wanted the ring, he he kind of blew it off, and I just forgot about it. I said, I don't think he's going to do it at all. But on that night, after the ceremony, in front of everybody, he got down on one knee and he proposed.
Well, the proposal was one of the most scariest times of my life because I had to do something that I was not used to doing ever in life. She told me when we was talking about me proposing to her was she wanted me to propose in front of a whole crowd of people. Well, a lot of y'all that know me know I'm not a people person, but I had to do it just to make her happy. So what I did was, as soon as I had to find the ring, me and my boy Kev was like, you know, hey, this the ring you think you might want? I'm like, whew, price ain't, but it's the ring I want. So, you know, man, we got the ring and I was kept on looking at it. I was like, okay, how I'm gonna do it? And I knew she had a hooding ceremony coming up at her graduation. And a hooding ceremony is a very intimate ceremony where the people in her profession hood her for her accomplishment of graduating. So I was sitting there the whole time of the hooding ceremony, I was just sweating. I mean, it was going so bad, everybody else, but it was going quick to me. So I just feel like I was gonna get on one knee at the end of the ceremony in front of everybody and just surprise them with the engagement. Okay, so the ride up there, I mean, like I said, it was just scary. Like, I was just counting down the minutes. It's like time was going slow for everybody else. But time was on crack for me. So I was like, as soon as it was over with, I tried to kneel up over there. You know, I tried to do it quietly, you know, but I can't do it quietly because she started screaming as soon as I got on one knee. So as soon as I got on one knee, thankfully, because her screaming so loud, I didn't have to say much. I just had to get on one knee and look good. So once I look good, you know, I try to get the ring on the finger. Then everybody start turning around. I'm like, oh, okay, here the eyes looking. So, you know, I try to get up and try to do it right quick before I just start sweating because I don't like being in front of a whole bunch of people. So once I did it, you know, she gave me a hug. And I know after then, like, I did that for her. So that became the best day of my life as well as the best day of her life as well.
10 years from now, I see Ravi and I with our own business. I see us continuing to be in love, enjoying each other, with maybe one or two children, but just enjoying and loving life, enjoying and loving each other.
Okay, in 10 years, I just see us owning our own business, owning our own mental health therapy business. Also, I just see us having about 2 or 3 kids, you know, just living, just being in my backyard. Like, I'm a real private person, so I just see us in our backyard just enjoying each other, just enjoying our children, and also, you know, enjoying more dogs. We recently raised our first pit bull together, so I see us having more of them in the future as well. The biggest accomplishment that we had together, well, at first, when I graduated college, I didn't know I was going to go to master's school. I didn't know I was going to get my master's degree or nothing like that. That wasn't even in the picture, but she motivated me to do that. And it's like, man, I don't know, because she wasn't going to be going to school the same year as I do, so I was going to be going there by myself. But, I mean, she just helped me support it through the whole time. And 2 years later, I found myself graduating with a master's degree that I didn't know I can get without her. So, I mean, that just lets you know right there that not only is she there for me, you know what I'm saying, but she wanted to see me just to my full potential. And any woman that does that just deserves to be, you know, my wife.
Ravi and I's biggest accomplishment together is that we both have obtained our master's degrees. I love the fact that we waited to get married, although many people say that we took a very long time, and we got the question for now 6 years, when are you guys going to get married? But we developed a plan early on within our relationship, and that, to me, that's a great accomplishment to say that we planned our lives and we're following through. Ravi, my sweet Ravi, today is the wedding day. I know that we've been waiting on this day for over a year now. I love you with all my heart. I could not ask for a better husband, a better friend, a better lover. You're everything wrapped in one, and I love you dearly. That will never change. I love you, babe.
All right, Denise, just want to let you know I love you. This is our day that we experienced together. You know, I just want to thank you for just doing this with me and just making this happen and making this possible for me. You know, we thought it was going to be a long way, but here it is. It's our day, and I just hope you enjoy it as much as I do. And I hope you just as feel as special as I do, because I love you like I love you as many years to come.
How much I